gravitational constant capital G. Now we have to calculate this gravitational constant G. First of all, this universal gravitational constant is experimentally determined by a scientist, English scientist, that is Henry Cavendish. Henry Cavendish, and this Henry Cavendish determined this G value experimentally in 1798 year. And that Henry Cavendish experimental procedure and the experimental schematic diagram is as follows. Here, this is the support. For this support, he attached a fine string. And for this string, again, he considered AB is the rod. And for this rod, here, two smaller spherical lids. He considered two smaller spherical lids. And nearer to this smaller spherical lids, again, he considered the spheres, bigger spheres, that is S1, and here one more sphere, that is S2 sphere. Here he considered these bigger spheres nearer to this smaller lead spheres on either side of this rod AB. That means this S1 and S2 are the opposite side. Here, when these bigger spheres are brought nearer to this rod AB or this smaller spheres, then the gravitational force of attraction between these two smaller sphere and this bigger sphere attracting, that the gravitational force of attraction is acting between this smaller sphere and this bigger sphere. And here there is no net force acting on this rod, because here two equal forces are acting between this smaller sphere and bigger sphere. Here also one more force. These two are equal and acting in the opposite direction. Then there is no net force acting on this rod AB, but only a torque is acting on this rod AB. Here, due to the torque, this thread is twisted by an angle theta. Here, this thread is twisted by an angle theta. Then the positions of this bigger spheres are changing, like this is S1 dash and this is S2 dash. Here, these are the, now this torque is acting between these spheres, then this thread is twisted by an angle theta. Here, this is called a gravitational torque, and the gravitational torque is equal to the force and the length of this rod. Here, gravitational force F is equal to, I am writing, the mass of this bigger sphere is capital M and mass of the smaller sphere is small m, and the distance between these two spheres is small d. Then the gravitational force of attraction between these two spheres is gmm by, and the distance here I am taking d square. The distance is d, then d square. This is the gravitational force, and the gravitational torque, that is equal to gravitational force is multiplied with the length of the rod L. Now the gravitational torque is equal to gmm by d square into L. This is, I am taking equation 1. Now on this rod, when it is twisted by an angle theta, then again after some time, again it comes to the original position, it comes to the equilibrium position, by the restoring torque acting on this rod. Here, that restoring torque is directly proportional to the theta. The restoring torque is directly proportional to the angle theta. Now, the restoring torque. Restoring torque is equal to tau into theta. This is equation 2 I am taking. Now, by this, this is the gravitational torque and this is the restoring torque. Here, these two torques are equal at the equilibrium. Now, by that, equation 1 and equation 2 are equal. Then, G capital M small m by d square into capital L is equal to tau into theta. Here, all the values we know, this is capital M, mass of the sphere, and small m is mass of the lead sphere, smaller sphere, and d is the distance between these two spheres, and L is the length of the rod, and tau is the torque acting on the rod, and theta is the angle of twisting. Now, by this, we can get the gravitational constant capital G. That is, capital G is equal to tau into theta into d square by G m m into L. By this, we can calculate the gravitational constant. Here, simply, Henry Cavendish considered a fine thread attached to a rod AB. For this AB rod, at the ends of this AB rod, two smaller lead spheres are attached. And this is given by a support. And consider two bigger spheres of capital mass M, and these two spheres, between these two spheres, the gravitational force is acting. Here, at this side the gravitational force is acting, and this side also the gravitational force is acting, and these two forces are equal and acting in the opposite direction. Then the torque is acting on this AB rod. That means that is the gravitational torque, and the gravitational torque is equal to the gravitational force into length of the rod L, that is G mm by d square into L. Then, because of this gravitational torque, it moves at these distances. Again, after some time, again it comes to the equilibrium position, then the restoring torque is equal to tau into theta. That these two torques are equal in the equilibrium position, then by this we can get G is equal to tau into theta into d square by G mm into L.